All right, so I just wanted to record a little video to show you how I would work on a draft in the sandbox on Wikipedia. So I'm on wikipedia.org and logged in, and I can just go to my sandbox right here. And this is a place that I have to work as a testing spot and page development space for me. I'm gonna edit this. I could also edit source if I wanted to work in the source code editor, but I find the GUI a little bit easier to use. And it says edit below this line. So I'm just gonna put some empty space in there. And I saw that no one had claimed Jen Lowe as a Wikipedia article. So I'm gonna use her as an example. So I'm gonna create a heading first. And I'm just gonna put her name in here to make it look a little more official. You can't really put a title into the sandbox because it's this kind of interstitial space, but I could make some other headings. I'm definitely gonna want a references section. And then if you've watched the tutorials, you know you can insert more and then references list, and then that will automatically generate a reference list as you work. So the first thing I need is kind of the overview sentence about her. So I'm gonna go to Google and I'm just gonna search for Jen Lowe in quotation marks. And this is not who I want here, this musical artist. I want this Jen Lowe who is a data artist. And I'm gonna open up her personal webpage, even though I can't cite it directly. I can use it to help me find search terms that will give me good sources. So, I'm going to just say that Jen Lowe is an artist who works with data. It's just a very simple introductory sentence. And there isn't always a citation for that first sentence if you go look at examples, but then as a rule of thumb, I think it's good to have a citation for basically every sentence after that. And so what I know about Jen is that she's really known for this project, One Human Heartbeat. And I can see that there's an article from FastCo that's linked here. So I'm gonna right click and open that in a new tab. And this is an article which I think would count as a source, as a third-party source. I'm gonna copy this link so that I can cite it later. And then I'm gonna write a sentence about it. Then I've got a sentence and I should stick a citation at the end. I'm gonna click the cite button and then I'm just gonna paste in the URL and click generate. And then it'll automatically make a citation and do its best to pick out the right fields. You can also do it manually, but this looks like it worked pretty well. It's got the author, the date, the title, the publishing source, and then when I retrieved it. So I can just say insert. And now I've got the little link there. And I've got something in my references list. And I can keep working this way to look and see, you know, some other things that she's done. Looks like she co-founded the School for Poetic Computation. So I might want to go and Google that. And then I'm going to look for any type of article. This is from vice.com. So that looks like it could be a good third-party source. Okay, and it's even in this sort of like subtitle or nut graph of the article. So I'm going to copy this. And I'm pretty sure there's a Wikipedia article on the School for Poetic Computation. So I'm going to make a link directly to that Wikipedia article. I'm going to do two square brackets to get the automatic sort of search bar to pop up. All right, and then I want a citation. And again, I'm just gonna paste the link and click generate and then insert and it shows up. So I could keep working like this, putting in sentences, trying to make it flow as best I can, but trying to keep my sentences as neutral as possible. And this is looking like the beginning of a draft of an article. But if it was you and you were working, just because you've put something into your sandbox doesn't mean I can necessarily see it. You'd need to publish your changes, which would put this stuff on Wikipedia in public, but again, just in your sandbox. So mine is gonna go into the user Amelia MN sandbox. It's not going to wikipedia.org/JenLowe. So that's how I'd like you to do this. You can publish changes and I can type like first draft of JenLowe article. And then publish changes. And now if you go to my Wikipedia sandbox, you can see this little draft that I've worked on. So that's what I'd like you to have done for each of your articles.